Hey guys, today I wanted to do a Heartstopper review. So I have seen this show twice now. I literally just finished watching it for the second time. And I mean, oh, I just love it so much. I'm gonna tell you my thoughts and opinions and just about the show. Yeah, so this series is obviously very popular, you know, right now. It literally like got so popular in like 1 week. It was in like the top 10. I swear, in like a couple of days or something. I don't even know. But as it should be. I absolutely adore this show. It is my comfort show. I'll just like read the little synopsis for you. Just to give you a quick little insight into what it is. Stuck in a secret relationship, shy Charlie starts to crush on Nick, the school's popular rugby star, and joins the team against his friend's advice. And then basically from that, you know, feelings start to grow. Yeah, that's basically the concept of it. Obviously, this series has a target audience, and this series is not going to be for everyone, but I freaking adore it. I love it. So, opinions. I love every character in this, to be fair. Like, every single character I love, apart from Ben and Harry. And we know why. Nick is my favorite character. He has my heart. Love you, Nick. Obviously, the creator and the author, Alice Oseman, I think that's how you say her name. I'm sorry if I got that wrong. She obviously created these, and these were originally web comics. And then they got published into actual comics, which I do really want to read, actually. And then it was made into a series. So I love how the whole series is still kind of, you know, comic style. Just the little graphics that they have, the little like drawings, that sketch style that you see in comics, and like they have that in the series. Love those like little moments, the leaves and the little love hearts and the little sparks that fly on screen. I love all of that. That's really cute. Like, first time watching it, like I was like, oh my god, this is actually beautiful. And second time watching it, I was just like, this is just even more beautiful than I remembered. And then I cried, obviously, both times, because it is it's that cute that I cried. It's cute, it's wholesome, it's beautiful, it's just so endearing. It's just so like, oh, my heart. It's so comforting and like just, oh. Another thing I want to mention is the music in this series. I really like the music. It really fits with the whole vibe. I adore it. I also love the fact that they actually use like real teenagers to play teenagers, instead of 27-year-olds playing 18-year-olds or whatever. No, well, they're not even 18 in this, playing 15-year-olds. I love the fact that they actually use kids. I'm gonna kind of go through the characters and just say like who I like and not. So Charlie, obviously, I do like Charlie. And obviously, like, I feel sorry for him because, you know, he's literally being picked on for being gay, which is horrible. I really like his character, though. He's really cute. Nick, I adore. I actually love him so much. Yeah, he's my fave. Tao. I do like Tao, but I, like, sometimes, no, he's okay. And I understand where he's coming from. Like, I get that he wants to protect Charlie, because obviously Nick's friends aren't really that nice, and they're all like the rugby lads and like the popular like annoying boys, you know, that he's having school. So I get that he like wants to protect Charlie and everything, like that's totally, you know, I get that. Like, I understand that, like, he probably is kind of jealous because he's obviously, Charlie's getting like a new friend, and so he's like being pushed side, kind of. I don't know. Yeah, I get that, to be fair, but he's not my fave character. And I also think that they did Tao's hair dirty. Like, honey, what is that hairstyle? William Gao. I don't know his last name. Gao? William Gao's hair in real life is gorgeous. Leave it the way it is in the show. Please, do not flip it up like that. What are you doing? I do like L. And I like that L and Tao, I like their relationship. And I hope that if season 2 comes out, which it should, they can get closer and like actually go out, because like it's so obvious that they both like each other. Like, how have they not realized this yet? Like, wait, are you dumb? Isaac, he's not really like, you know, in it that much. He's kind of just a little side character, but he's really cute and nice. Book nerd, which is cute. Yeah, I do like him. We don't really see much of him to like have a full-on opinion about him. I like Darcy and Tara. They're really cute together. I find Imogen quite cringy at times. bless her. Lol. She's just trying to shoot her shot, isn't she? I hate Ben. Don't like Ben. He needs to sort his shit out, because he's... And I hate Harry and all of the rugby boys, actually. That's annoying! I love that this show has representation for many sexualities and identities, and I just love it. I think they do it really well, and it's just a fun series. It's just such a soft, oh, lovable series. Everyone suits their character so well. Kit Connor, who plays Nick, he's literally Nick in real life. And he was actually in Rocketman. He played young Elton John, which I literally found that out when I first watched it, and I was like, what? Like, he looks so different. He's just got a baby face. But anyway, he was really good in this though. I really liked Kit Connor's acting. He kind of shone for me in this, not gonna lie. So did Ben. I think Ben Hope, he was really good in this. Sebastian Croft plays him, he's good. And I think Charlie was really good in this as well. I've forgotten his name in real life. Joe Locke, who plays Charlie Spring. He was really good in this. They were all good. Other than that, it was really good and I loved it. I also love the fact that Alice Oseman is also the executive producer, one of them. I think that's great that they did that, because obviously she can actually have input into this series and help with the process and actually bring it to life. It's her comics, it's her ideas, so I think that's good that they made her an executive producer. This is another great thing about this. It's literally 25 minutes each episode, and there's 8 episodes. Like, that's bingeable. So this show is very bingeable. So if you need a show, a quick little show to watch, then watch this, because it's perfect if you like this sort of stuff. I would say about the show, one thing that I noticed, as it is cringy, but like it's bound to be cringy because it's literally a teen drama, like about relationships, friendships, school, whatever. So like it's gonna be cringy, but like it's still cute anyway. We look past that. Another thing I would say about this, another criticism, I'm sorry, is the acting sometimes just falls flat a bit. Like, they are really good actors, to be fair. Like, young actors. I mean, they're not even that young. They're literally, like, my age. But they're considered young actors, I guess. But they are really good. But sometimes the acting is just a bit like, ooh. Like, that was just, like, cringe. You know what I mean? Really like the second episode and the last episode. They loved them. I liked every episode. Oh my god. The second episode and the last episode really shone for me. I loved them. And I really liked... Oh, I liked the second to last episode. The seventh episode. Where they go to the cinema. But I like every single episode, honestly. And altogether, this show is really good. I hope that season 2 comes out, because... that would be amazing. Because there's still... Alice Oseman has made... obviously the series of comics, and there's different volumes, and apparently in volume 3 or volume 2, I could be wrong, they go to Paris for a school trip, and everything like that. And I think that'd be so cute if they did that. So I hope they do. That is my feelings and thoughts and opinions about Heartstopper. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in my next video. Watch Heartstopper on Netflix now. It's great, you'll love it. Okay, thank me later. Peace out.